Finally, Elden Ring review is here. What's up, my boys and girls? How are you these days? I hope all of you are doing fine these days, but if you are not, we are here to make you smile at least for a little. Today we will talk about Elden Ring and my personal adventure on it. Oh yes, baby. I will try to give you as many as possible information about the gameplay, but warning ahead, there will be some spoilers about the backstory, bosses and generally the game, so if someone hasn't played it yet or he's playing it this period, it would be good for him to avoid this video. Last but not least, I would like to mention that this is only my personal opinion about Elden Ring and how I experienced it through my eyes. So, don't waste more time. Let's dive on it immediately. Grab your food, your drinks, and enjoy an amazing journey to a wonderful and beautiful world. FromSoftware managed to respond for one more time as well as we expected and brought to us a magnificent world in which if we dive one time, we will truly live a wonderful adventure. Yes, boys and girls, Elden Ring made a huge entry in the gaming industry, grabbing the attention not only from gamers of the last Souls games, but generally. The company has won the recognition of world in the last years, as all Souls titles were diamonds from the time they were published until now. Hidetaka Miyazaki, the creator of the Souls titles, always obliged all the players to show interest about his games, both for his special cosmology and for his hard gameplay, which of course made the very first titles so popular. Staying loyal to his prototype's titles, he continued and created two more diamonds, Bloodborne and Sekiro, while now he decided to build his wonderful game based on the foundations of the world and the myth which George Martin created, without of course quitting the style which characterizes the games. Elden Ring is now in a new world and time, not so dark as the old ones, yet we find a lot of dark places playing this as it is magnificently huge. You will face silent, tragic stories of the residents of the lands between with their own special way. Of course, from the first cinematic which we will watch in the start of the game, as FromSoftware always are used to do, we will realize that the common backstory is here too. A tarnished, a cursed, poor soul is as necessary as the huge world is. One of the many cursed who were exiled when the Elden Ring was broken. Of course, six demigods tried to claim all the broken pieces and runes, managing only to turn their own selves in an abnormal and corrupted version. Of course, the main story, as in the previous ones, tarnished from all over the world, came here with one big dream to achieve. Their duty is to collect all of the pieces of the runes as it is time for a big, huge change. And yes, there is no other change than beating the gods and having a new Elden Lord. For all the tryhard gamers who played all the previous games, it is common that the story doesn't yell its presence, but FromSoftware is trying to keep it alive so that we will be able to discover it by ourselves, by playing the game and our walkthrough. A huge question will be, yes, but how we can do that while playing the game? Elden Ring is full of cinematics with background voices, many dialogues you can discover in your playthrough from NPCs that are either trying to help you or to stop you, backgrounds of the items you can collect, and of course, the monsters. As I was playing the game for the first time in my first playthrough, I was so excited that I didn't give big attention in the enemies who I was fighting to. The freak monsters which we are fighting are not something more than creatures who are in their metal or physical collapse, or the huge and enormous bosses who, except from their corrupted nature, they have invisible aspects. I know that all of these are very complicated to understand the backstory of the game, but I believe that is one thing which manages to keep you interested in the game and keep exploring it. Last but not least, do not forget, believe me or not, there are still until now people which discover something new about the old titles. Imagine how big and chaotic is every story behind these cinematics and generally the cosmology of these kind of games. Now, a big change which personally I loved was the new environment. As we can still remember from the previous games, there were huge maps, huge buildings, and generally huge roads you could take in order to finish the game. But now we have something new and more attractive. The game now is created in a huge open world. yes, in a huge open world, which gives you the ability to travel whenever you want without stopping you, which creates to you a huge fear as you are thinking, where this freedom is going to lead me? Yes, I know that the maps from the previous titles were big enough to get lost as you are exploring it, but I mean, come on guys, have you tried to explore Elden Ring only with our loved horse Torrent? You will truly get lost in the first 5 minutes. Of course, from the first steps you will take to the game, you will realize something we said previously. The world now seems more alive and brightened, in a more earthly world, while the magnificent earth tree stands in the back of the world so bright which is going to blind you if you look it for a long time. Playing now, you will realize that is a more realistic cycle of the day, as day and night come and go, making you to dive even further into the game. Of course, weather conditions are here too, helping you or not, even with fog or with heavy rain, making you to think about your playstyle, you will beat your enemy. And when I'm saying playstyle, I mean that either you are going as the classic way towards him and provoking him without fear, or by your new stealth way so you can achieve a critical hit. Yes, you heard right, there is a stealthy way now. Even by standing in a long grass or hiding behind trees and walking slowly in order to get closer to your enemy. Now we are even more free to dive as deep as we want in the world in challenges of Elden Ring, as the map is much more larger and open so you can avoid anything and play with your own strategy. You can feel it a little easier than the last ones, but don't make yourself to believe something like that. It is not. There's just more control on what you want to do. For example, as you take the first step into the game after the tutorial, you will find a huge cavalryman boss standing into your way. Oh my god, I hate this guy. He may be one of the most hated bosses into the game as he is very strong and he is truly into your 5 minutes playthrough. The good is that you can avoid him, grind for as long as you want and come back to kill him much more easy than before. The ability to avoid the attacks, to approach another gameplay with your own strategy and mainly to play the game by your own pace is one of the biggest play Miyazaki and Martin made for it. But of course, don't ever believe that the game is much easier than the old ones. If you do something like that, I believe your keyboard and your controller are surely in danger. It still needs hours of grinding and practicing on your skills in order to finish it and beat the Elden Lord. Practice makes you perfect, they say. Of course, only when you are choosing your way to play. And here we will meet the classes of the game. When you will start the game, you will be asked to choose our main class for your run. You can choose between of hero, warrior, vagabond, samurai, wretch, bandit, confessor, astrologer, prophet and prisoner. These options will determine your characteristics and your gear, without this means that you will be restricted with these stats. As in the old ones, either you play with a mage, with a warrior, with huge weapons, or you like high dexterity, nothing is going to stop you if you want to deviate. Of course, the keepsakes or gifts in the start of your class are items which will help you in the early game as they concern more HP, upgrades for health flasks, or extra keys for secret areas. Last, the character creation is much more detailed, but you don't have to spend hours and hours in it as it is a procedure which can be made again in your playthrough. Playing one of the FromSoftware games, you will never be ready as you can discover a new difficulty as you walk into the map, starting to explore the secrets, which are hidden in lands between. You will face 6 demigods, who are ready to devour you anytime. In the boss fights remains the classic way as from the old games, the sizes remain extra big, as always, and of course, every time you discover a new way that a boss can kill you and make you suffer. So, be patient, grind as much as you can, keep a good pace, and of course, don't break anything from the many rage quits which are going to happen. Sadly, not only bosses are something which is going to make you suffer. There are a huge variety of enemies with different patterns and moves, many mini bosses hidden in secret dungeons, and giants whom you will be scared to approach them. In all of this, Torrent will help you in many ways. Of course, Torrent is a loyal horse, which you can take it in your first 20 minutes of your playthrough, and it is going to accompany you until the very end. Torrent will be very helpful in Elden Ring because you will be able to travel around the world much easier and faster. Also, Torrent has the ability to be immune to poison, so no more rage quits in swamps which trying to devour you either with poison or with scarlet rot. Of course, all these only in open world areas when you can call Torrent. In dungeons or closed castles you will not be able to call your loyal horse. You will be forced to walk and pass these annoying swamps. Last but not least, except from the double jump which Torrent has, and it will be very helpful, you can fight as you ride him, giving you the boost in your physical attacks. You will understand the value Torrent has when you will realize the size of the map at the end of your first playthrough. So, my little riders, of course, you will have the questions like, what is there on the other side of the map? But please be careful because you are in a world of FromSoftware, and as it is pretty common, maybe huge drakes are lurking around you. As reference is concerned about the combat, it is pretty similar with the old title. As mage, you mainly have your spells, and believe me, mages are very powerful in Elden Ring. The basic hits are exactly the same, and of course, their role too. But the huge change which they made and managed to have a better combat system is by giving into our character the ability to jump. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you heard right. Now we have a button so we can jump and jump attack, which makes a powerful hit, which leads almost every enemy to interrupt his current move. So, get ready for your jump attack spams. Another useful way to fight is by summoning. And you will ask me, what is summoning in Elden Ring, George? Summoning is pretty an ability to summon spirits in order to fight with you, and they are always monsters you already fought in your playthrough. Get ready to take some help from jellyfish, ghouls, archers, warriors, mages, and much more. Of course, in order to achieve that, you will have to collect them one by one, either from the grounds hidden in dark places or by defeating bosses in merry areas. Spirits can be upgraded too from NPCs, and believe me, they are going to fight and serve you until death. Last but not least, something I would like to mention because I found it very useful is that now you don't use your stamina to run to jump, but you use it only when you are in combat or an enemy is chasing you. That gave us the ability to travel much faster because we can run as much as we want except when we are interrupted. Of course, reading articles on social media, I read complaints about the map which there is now in Elden Ring. For someone who hasn't played it yet, you will not know that now your character has a map button in which the areas of the map are closed until you loot them from the ground. It is not so hard though to collect them as they are pretty marked in your map from the start. Yes, you heard right, FromSoftware game has a map now. And come on guys, I mean, there is a huge size of open world, 6 big areas, which every area has its demigod, and many secret places on each of it. It would be a shame if they didn't use a map so you can navigate much easier on it. So, for the bonfires now. I mean, the graces, I'm sorry. Brighter world means that there are no bonfires but lost graces, which you have to discover them. And of course, you can fast travel through them only when you have touched them wherever and whenever you want, except from specific times, such as when you are in combat or in dungeons. Graces are very different from the bonfires at their look, but in your actions are pretty similar. You can change your daytime. For example, some bosses they will be found only at midnight and not at the day. First of all, you can change your spells. You can, of course, level up while collecting runes and not souls anymore. Send some stuff in your chest so you don't have to carry all of them. Upgrade or increase your flasks. Of course, only under the condition that you have the items which are needed. Golden seeds and sacred tears. Golden seeds are scattered around the world under some golden trees, and sacred tears can be found in all churches. In addition, you can be helped by changing the balances from your health flasks, with your mana ones, subtracting from the one and increasing the other, while you can surely appreciate the fact that when you kill a team of enemies, your flasks can be replaced. You can also change Ashes of War into your equipment, a new kind of enchantment or ability, tell it as you want, which give into the weapons special moves. Of course, you can also rest as much as you want, which basically is end the pause of the game, as there is not a specific button for pausing the game. At last, your collection of your drinkable items will be enriched through your crafting, a new way into the game to help you in many situations. Crafting can be used to craft darts, arrows, bombs, and so many other items using only materials you can collect from the nature. For the more specific recipes, you will have to buy books from merchants around the world or to loot them from the ground in hidden different ways. This will unlock you a huge variety of items you can craft. Of course, as every FromSoftware game amazes us with a special way every time, we will find something like that and in Elden Ring. You will not believe how big is Elden Ring except when you will take decision to play. There is a huge underground map with four huge places to discover and fight your way through. One of these is the Sofra River, which is trying to get away from the medieval aesthetic and brings us a sky full of stars, even though we are underground, with temples and acropolis which are defended by scary monsters and orbs, which can almost one-shot our character. This enormous freedom of traveling whenever you want can help you but can punish you as well. I mean, the grind of 4 levels and the explore of better equipment will be much easier, but you never know what is lurking down there while it is ready to attack you anytime. In conclusion, I would say that Elden Ring may be one of the best games of all time, if it isn't the best, of course, always by my opinion. While I was playing, I was truly lost on it, and I would suggest to everyone play this. Either you are not a gamer of this kind of games, you should definitely try this experience. FromSoftware decided to amaze us with their new discoveries and gave us a game we all wanted. I would say we took what FromSoftware promised to us, from the start until now. If you would ask if I found something negative about Elden Ring, my answer would be no. You already know that. The new world which is worth to be explored, the new mechanics were necessary in order to operate this huge open world model. We are facing an amazing level design with an epic fantasy world created by Miyazaki and Martin, while the rich lore is lurking behind every corner. You have the freedom to do whatever you want, to travel whenever you want, and to experiment the huge variety of weapons and spells while you are engraving your own path. Ladies and gentlemen, we present you Elden Ring, the Lord of all Souls titles. Oh my god, what an amazing video was. Even when I'm just talking about Elden Ring, I feel something incredible. Imagine how I was feeling when I was playing that. Guys, I definitely suggest it to you. You should buy it and play it as deep as you can. You will realize what a great job FromSoftware made. I can't describe more. So, I should close the video and let you go and buy Elden Ring. I hope all of you enjoyed the video and I managed to give you some information about the game. If you truly did, please show us some love by smashing the like button and of course the subscribe button to become one of us. In addition, comment down below and give us some ideas for other videos, comment how you feel, so we can communicate with you. From your loved boy, George, stay safe, stay strong, because these days are hard, love your humans, and of course, stay tuned, because more are coming soon. See you on the next video.